Oh my. Total country vibes.
Yeah.
Welcome back to Wave React, everybody.
Today I'm going to show Zach an album I really love. And even if he doesn't love it, you'll get to see me love it. So we'll see how it goes.
Here we go. I'm doing good, I'm on some new shit. Been saying yes instead of no. I thought I saw you at the bus stop, I didn't though. Taylor Swift.
Finally got to T Swift. I hit the Sunday matinee. You know the greatest films of all time were never made.
Is this new or old?
2020. Folklore. If you wanted
me, you really should have showed. And if you never bleed, you're never gonna grow. And it's all right now. And it's another day waking up alone. But we were something, don't you think so? Dope. Roaring I like twenties, it. Tossing
pennies in the pool. It's minimal. And if my wishes came true, it would have been you. In my defense, I have none. I persist and resist the temptation to ask you if one thing had been different. You would have been the one.
Ooh. I really like whatever that sound is. It's kind of going throughout the song.
Yeah.
That was cool.
The production on this is interesting. So Aaron Dessner from the National Big Red Machine produced half of this, most of this.
This has always intrigued me, this album, because I love the National.
Yeah.
Always wanted to explore this album, so I'm glad that we're doing it now.
Yeah. So yeah, the producer, Jack Antonoff, who I love, does Bleachers. He was in...
Fun, right?
Yeah, Fun.
Yeah, Fun. Yeah. Okay. Yeah.
This album was made during COVID, all remote. Aaron, you know, he produced a lot of this, and he was working on it in secret. But he would have bandmates from the National work on it. And he's like, he didn't tell them who it was. And even like the day before it came out, like they didn't know they were going to be on a Taylor Swift album.
Cool.
Which is wild.
That's pretty neat.
That was The One, which is kind of about reminiscing on if you would have stuck with somebody, you know, what might have been. Next one's Cardigan. This was the single off the album. Vintage tea, brand new phone, high heels on cobblestones. When you are young, they assume you know nothing. I like how the beat kind of like high heels on cobblestones.
Mm-hmm. Sequin smile, black lipstick, sensual politics. When you are young, they assume you know nothing. But I I really like how the piano is the dominant instrument, but then there's all this kind of like chaos going on, but really quiet. I know it works. Really cool percussion.
Mm-hmm.
Man, her lyrics are so good.
Phew.
It felt like I was an old cardigan under someone's bed. You put me on and said I was your favorite. I love that. Like reverse.
Yeah. Yeah, Aaron did some really cool things on this.
Yeah, that was really neat.
There's three songs on this album, and it's like a love triangle. So that song is from the perspective of Betty.
Okay.
So what's different about this album from other Taylor Swift albums is this is all, quote, folk song. This album, she really tried to just like tell different stories, whether made up or...
Okay.
So yeah, there's like a love triangle on here, which is interesting. So
I always figured, like, I don't know, hearing that the National was in some way, you know, involved, and then the Folklore name and just like the album cover and stuff, to me, I always thought it was more of like an indie, more down-tempo, less pop kind of album.
Which it is.
Okay. So yeah, a little bit of both, but cool. Yeah, no, I really like that one.
Yeah, you mentioned pop, so it's interesting because like the structure is very pop because it's Taylor Swift, but it is like indie, down-tempo. So it's an interesting mix, in my opinion.
And I like you had mentioned on the previous song, I really like just so far how minimal everything is, and the production is super clean too. Mm-hmm. So yeah, really nice.
Awesome. This next one's The Last Great American Dynasty.
Rebecca rode up on the afternoon train. It was sunny. Her salt box house on the coast took a mind off St. Louis. The wedding was charming, if a little gauche. There's only so far new money goes. They picked out a home and called it Holiday House. And they said, there goes the last great American dynasty.
So this song is actually about a real person that existed named Rebecca.
Kind of got that vibe just because of some of the lyrics, like the Standard Oil dynasty and stuff like that.
She had a marvelous time ruining everything. 50 years is a long time.
Really cool drums. It's like a thing over here. There it is.
So now you heard that part. So it's about this house, but she actually bought the house and she lives in it now.
Oh, okay.
There's a little twist here at the end.
There goes the loudest woman this town has ever seen. I had a marvelous time ruining everything. I had a marvelous time.
So she kind of flipped it from Rebecca. Now she's saying like, she's kind of taken over her role. So yeah, I said it wasn't autobiographical, but she did work her way into the story, which is interesting.
Really cool.
Yeah. And St. Louis got a mention there.
Yeah. Shout out.
So this next one's called Exile, featuring Bon Iver. So
nice.
I think I've shared this one with you, but I don't know if you actually listened to it. That's why we started this channel.
I can see you standing, honey, with his arms around your body.
Coming in with his deep voice.
Joke's not funny at all.
I can actually understand him.
Yeah.
And it took you 5 whole minutes. I think I've seen this film before. And I didn't like the ending.
Ooh.
You're not my homeland anymore. So what am I defending now?
Man,
he kills
it. This is beautiful.
I can see you staring, honey, like he's just your understudy, like he'd get your knuckles bloody for me. Now I'm in exile, seeing you out. I think I've seen this film before. So I'm leaving out the side door.
So step right out.
There's
no amount of cry I can do for all this time. We always want.
man, their voices fit so well together.
Yeah. And it just builds and builds so well. There's this like drum echo. Something there. I love it.
Mm-hmm.
Gorgeous. Epic duet. So that was actually written by Taylor and her boyfriend. Her boyfriend has a deep register like that.
Oh,
and
cool.
She said she'd always wanted to work with Justin. And, you know, she's like, Aaron, you're friends with Justin. Is there any way you can get him on this? And she was amazed that he actually did this. And then he came on and he wrote a few lines. So step right out. That's, I know he wrote that part. Everybody's like, that's classic.
Yeah, that Justin. Sounds like him. And it's cool because I joked at the beginning like that you can understand him. I love Justin Vernon. It is interesting to hear him come through a little bit more clear than what you'd hear on one of his records. And there was sometimes kind of towards like the pre-chorus or kind of some of the buildups where you'd hear like, you know, kind of synthesizer that he would normally use, but like really, really subtle in the mix, and it would just kind of weave. And that's what I've noticed about this album is a lot of the production and instrumentation just like weave in such a beautiful way.
Yeah.
Yeah. I'm really enjoying this so far.
Awesome. Yeah. When it came out, so it was like a surprise release. She didn't tell anybody about it. And she's like, oh, tomorrow I got a new album coming out.
Classic.
And yeah, I dug into it and like I was hooked. Just the vibe of it was unexpected from her.
I've always wanted to get around to it. I just I never have. So I'm glad that, yeah, that you're showing it to me tonight.
Awesome. Yeah. And I think she was smart not promoting this up to it because it is so different from her other stuff. I feel like if people heard a single without hearing the whole album, they'd be like, what is this?
Yeah. And I mean, if you look at like people who were, I Knew You Were Trouble back then or whatever, you know, versus this, I mean, yeah, it's a very different vibe.
Totally. So next one is my favorite on the album.
Nice.
My Tears Ricochet.
Cool.
Never knowing what they'll mean. Some to throw, some to make a diamond ring. You know I didn't want to.
I like the vocoder.
Me too.
Behind her.
You wear the same jewels that I gave. All the vocal harmonies, really.
So good.
Beneath the waves, you had to kill me, but it killed you
Really cool.
So that song, you know, her whole deal with the record label, you know, buying her catalog. So that's what that song's about. So basically, if I'm like dead to you, why are you still saying my name and stuff? But there's, I feel like the instrumentation, you know, there's that build up, it drops out, and then it builds up really quick again.
Mm-hmm.
And to me, I feel like that represents her career. You know, she had this build up, country star, build up to a pop star, huge. And then that whole event happened and basically, you know, fell off. Well, then she came back and ricocheted, which is My Tears Ricochet. So I thought the production just was great for that whole build up.
That's portion. A really cool observation that totally makes sense. It was funny because right before that first build up, I was thinking, I was like, man, the one word for this album, I think, is ethereal. Like, it's definitely. Just so calm, you know, and then it started to kind of, you know, you get that synth bass and build up. But for the most part, I do feel like it's really ethereal and like you're in the, like the album cover fits perfectly for this album. That's interesting and a good way for her to express her frustrations with that, because I don't know much about that whole, what happened with her, but pretty slimy what the record label did, and the way that she's, you know, taking it into her own hands is just pretty awesome to say that, you know, I'm just going to re-record these really, 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 really similar and put them out and sell them all again.
Yeah. And the one part I like that speaks to that, she says, I still talk to you when I'm screaming at the sky. And then, and when you can't sleep at night, you hear my stolen lullabies. So she's talking about Scooter and them, you know. You can't sleep at night, you're hearing my music. But she's so good at being like petty like that. Next one, Mirrorball. I feel like this one's autobiographical too, even though she said these are folk songs.
Yeah.
I feel like this is her talking about fame and trying to please everybody. And yeah.
Which has got to be exhausting.
Yeah.
I'm sure. Yeah, totally. Her songwriting is just, I love her descriptiveness, the, you know, metaphors she uses. That reminded me of like indie rock on the production side. And for being someone who listens to the instruments first and usually the lyrics last, that's just how my brain works. A lot of her lyrics are standing out to me, just like little passages she has. I'm like, man, that's so clever. Mm-hmm. And
I think that might have to do with where it's in the mix. I feel like her vocals really sit on top of the mix because the instrumentation's so minimal.
Yeah, that's a good point. And she just has a very unique and, I don't know, just piercing voice. It's really easy to understand, for lack of a better word. But there's been several lines throughout the album so far that have caught my ear. And I'm like, wow, that's just good lyric writing right there.
Even though some people say she doesn't write her own songs.
That was a dude from Gorillaz and Blur. Right. He accused her of not writing her own song, saying, comparing to most pop stars or whatever, which Get out of here, dude.
Like, she came from country where she wrote her own stuff. So, like, she's not just going to stop doing that. Like, she always comes in with the idea and then they build on it.
So. Yeah. And having co-writers is not a... Collaboration is great.
All right. Next one. 7.
No more upbeat.
Yeah.
Sweet tea in the summer. Cross your heart, won't tell no other. And though I can't recall your face, I still got love for you. Your braids like a pattern. Love you to the moon and to Saturn. Pass down like folk songs. The love lasts so.
Song's about, pretty sure it's like a childhood friend either she had or this is made up, can't remember, but abusive dad. And so you pay attention to lyrics, that might help you.
Is that why it's called 7?
Yeah, like 7 years old. Yeah.
Okay.
Strings. I love artists that can just leave space for instruments like that.
Me too.
A lot of them are so... Especially pop, you know, they're driven toward radio, so it's got to be 3 minutes and all that, so they don't have any room for that.
But. Taylor has the power to just do whatever she wants, right. I feel like.
I mean, she had that 10-minute song, and it, like, went number one. Like, that's unheard of.
It's crazy. She still sells a million records in these days, so.
This next one is my second favorite. It's called August. Yeah, so this is also in the Love Triangle.
Okay.
Talked about earlier, and this is from the perspective of Augustine, the other woman in the triangle. So. This one's got a nice 90s feel, I think.
That was awesome.
Call and say, meet me behind the mall. So much for summer love, saying us, cause you weren't mine.
It's hard for me to pick a favorite so far. If I had to choose, I'd probably say that one. But this is an album I'm going to need to listen to a few times. Totally. I really like it, but I love Aaron from The National, and I feel like there's so much here that I really want to like closely Definitely. Pay attention to, because just the way that the production weaves in and out of these songs is just, it's so light, minimal, and beautiful. I don't know.
Speaking of production, this one was actually Jack Antonoff with, it looks like Joe is also credited, which is her boyfriend. And again, I feel it's interesting, you know, Aaron and Jack, they both kind of split up the album, but it's so cohesive for the most part. And it was all remote, like how they pulled that off.
Which is crazy, man. It's crazy.
This next one is This Is Me Trying. Another Jack. This song really speaks on like compassion, you know.
Totally.
You may be criticizing somebody, but they're probably, you know, trying their hardest.
Now that you had mentioned, you know, that it's kind of half and half on the production, I feel like I noticed some subtle differences. Like there was really cool because it almost sounds like Jack uses like some brass instruments a little bit. Like there it almost sounded like there was either a baritone or like a low French horn that kind of weaved in with the strings. It's just cool, all the orchestral elements. Definitely. Really.
This next one's Illicit Affairs, which is, what do you think it's about? Illicit Affairs?
Wholesome good stuff. Going out with your parents to the mall.
It's about cheating. Another Antonoff. This one has great visual lyrics too.
Make sure nobody sees you leave. Hood over your head, keep your eyes down. Tell your friends you're out for a run. You'll be flushed when you return. And that's the thing about illicit affairs and clandestine meetings and longing stares. It's born from just one single glance, but it dies and it dies and it dies a million little times. The perfume on the shelf that you picked out just for him, so you leave no trace behind. Don't call me baby. Look at this godforsaken mess that you made me. You showed me colors you know I can't see with anyone else. And you know damn well for you I would ruin myself a million.
Powerful lyric there.
Emotional.
Yeah.
Big time.
And that was from the perspective of the woman that's cheating with a married man, it sounds like.
Yep.
So, like, she's in love with him, but obviously it can never be anything more.
Yeah.
Great songwriting. All right, this next one, Invisible String. Just a beautiful song about love. This one's back to Aaron. Love the way she sings on this.
Isn't it just so pretty to think all along there was some invisible string tying you to me?
Ooh. Yeah.
Bad was the plot of the song in the cab on your first trip to LA.
Referencing her own song there, Bad Blood.
Meta.
Bold was the richest on our 3-year trip, getting lunch down by the lakes. She said I looked like an American singer. Something wrapped all of my past mistakes in barbed wire. Chains around my demons, wool to brave the seasons. One single thread.
Super cool.
About destined love, or
just the run she did with her voice throughout that whole song. Yeah. It felt very different. Yeah.
Cool stuff with the beat there. This next one's Mad Woman. Bet you can guess what it's about. Panning stuff happening.
And women like hunting witches too, doing your dirtiest work for you. They seem angry, again more angry. And there's nothing like a mad woman. What a shame she went mad. No one likes. There's an electric guitar back there. I'm waiting for it to come back. I don't know if it does.
Never heard of that before. The lyrics on that one, the part of like poking the bear, and then so it's almost like, you know, the man in the relationship will do something and then she freaks out about it, and then it's all because of her. It's not, he has nothing to do with the freak out, you know, just blaming her for being crazy whenever he was the one that like instigated it.
Beautiful instrumentation. The biggest thing I've noticed about the two producers on here is like when it's Aaron from the National, he does so much with panning. Like he'll bring in one little guitar bend into your right ear or your left ear or whatever. That's it's what constantly saying. Bouncing around.
There was like an electric guitar for a little bit of that. Just I was like, I never heard that before. And I was like, what is that?
Just a little bit. Yeah really, really sick. Cool.
So we skipped over this song by accident last time, so I'm gonna throw it in now.
Cool.
Here we go. This is called Epiphany.
Keep your helmet, keep
Beautiful, honestly.
Very angelic sounding, her voice here. Very cinematic soundtrack sound.
Feels like the first time we hear like synthesizers on the album.
Yep. I think there was a few other times, but it's so subtle. Even this is really subtle. Yeah.
Yeah, I really like that. It was one of my favorites, probably.
Awesome. So in the first verse, she's referring to like war. And then the second verse, she speaks on like COVID.
Super emotional. Yeah. Really, really like that.
This next one is Betty, which is the other Love Triangle song. But it's from the male's perspective. In
this. Okay.
And there's a part in this that sounds like an Owl City melody. I want to know if you pick up on it.
Betty, I won't make assumptions about why you switched your homeroom, but I think it's because of me. The worst thing that I ever did was what I did to you. But if I just showed up at your party, would you have me? Would you want me? Would you tell me to go fuck myself or lead me to the garden? Betty, I know where it all went wrong. Your favorite song was playing from the far side of the gym.
She's in her country bag on this one.
I was nowhere to be found. I hate the crowds, you know that. Plus, I saw you dance with him.
Like that part right there sounds like an Owl City melody to me, the way it's sung. But I'm crazy because I looked all around and I couldn't find the song.
I think you might just be crazy, man.
Probably.
Oh my. Total country vibes.
Yeah.
I like it.
You'll hear later she mentions Cardigan, which is the other song. Mm-hmm. And then she says, get in my car again. And that's referencing the other song when she's talking about the mall behind it.
Cool.
Meeting in the mall.
Betty, I'm here on your doorstep and I planned it out for weeks now, but it's finally sinking in. Standing in your cardigan.
Yeah, that part, I swear, it sounds like an Owl City melody.
Hoot Owls,
yeah.
Let us know.
Right. Although the Hoot Owls probably still mad at Taylor, so. She never messaged Adam back. I'm a little hurt about it.
I'm enchanted to meet you.
But I think Adam's better with who he's with. And this next song will kind of speak to that. Also, you got Bon Iver on this Pulse here production. Aaron took it from another session they had that they didn't use. But that's like classic Bon Iver.
Mm-hmm.
I never had the courage of my convictions as long as danger is near. And it's just around the corner, darling, because it lives in me. No, I could never give you peace. All these people think love's for show, but I would die for you in secret.
Love that line.
The devil's in the details, but you got a friend in me. Would it be enough if I could never give you peace? You're an integrity makes me seem small.
Sounds like a bass guitar.
I think it is, yeah.
I talk shit with my friends. It's like I'm wasting your honor. And you know that I'd swing with you for the fences, sit with you in the trenches, give you my wild, give you a child. There's robbers to the east, clowns to the west.
People say that's a Kanye line. Give you my best. Reference.
The rain is always gonna come if you're standing with me. Would it be enough if I could never give you peace?
So yeah, my take on that is, you know, she's famous, huge. You know, she's not going to have a normal life with whatever partner she's with. You know,
mm-hmm.
This other partner has to put up with a lot of stuff that he wouldn't normally have to. So I think that's what she means. You know, I can never give you peace, but I will do all these other things. You know, I will die for you in secret, which I think is such an epic line.
Probably my favorite on the album so far.
Sick. The next track is the official album closer, but then there's one more song after that that's a bonus, which we'll do for patrons. Next one is Hoax.
My only one, my smoking gun, stood on the cliffside screaming, give me a reason. Your faithless love's the only hoax I believe in. Don't want no other shade of blue.
It's like a synth back there or something.
You know I left.
Can't hear it anymore.
Back in New York, you knew the hero died, so what's the movie for? You knew it still hurts underneath my scars from when they pulled me apart. You knew the password, so I let you in the door. My only one, my kingdom.
I like that line. Kingdom come undone.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, that was awesome, man.
Betty, the one that was really country, is actually Jack and Aaron.
Oh, cool. So they did some co-producing as well.
And Swift as well. Swift has quite a bit of production credits. And I wonder what all that's about. If it's because she comes in, you know, with the guitar and they use the same melodies and stuff.
I didn't even think about that. I forgot that she is a guitar player as well.
I'm sure
there's
some guitar is
amazing guitar on that album. Overall, yeah, that was a great listen. I knew that was coming since the beginning of since we started this channel. I knew Taylor Swift would show up, but that was awesome, man. We're very open-minded when it comes to music, if you guys didn't know. Yeah. So if you dig album reviews like this, be sure to subscribe to our channel.
Yep. And if you're interested to do another Taylor Swift album, comment down below which album you think we should do.
And we will catch you guys in the next video. Unless you're a patron, then stick around because we got one more song to listen to. Yep. So
check that out.